No, six years old. Nakaingi.
Sa puso ko gusto.
At kapag para sa mga bata na,
hindi naman para ito. Ganon. Away. Ang soka. Ang
mula natin party.
Maglilingkod tayo sa isa't isa. Ito po, Dito Radio. Ang mga pananaw at opinyon ng pag-uulat na mag-uulat sa programang ito ay hindi ang pangunahing posisyon at pahayag ng organisasyong ito.
Paano nasimulan bilang isang doktor sa mga taong may kapansanan? Dok Toto.
Can you repeat the question, sir?
How did you start? Paano mo nasimulan bilang isang doktor ng may kapansanan, or how did you get started as a doctor in persons with disabilities?
I'm a medical doctor, by the way, for the benefit of the viewers. So I'm Dr. Chofilo de la Cruz Jr. They call me Doc Toto. I had my disability at the age of 16 when suddenly I cannot walk. And they discovered that my femoral heads, the ball and joint, seems like a ball and joint in our hips, was necrosed or napudpod in Tagalog. So I was third year high school then. I stopped schooling 1 year, but I really wanted to pursue with my education. So I finished my high school, then finished my college with Bachelor of Science in Biology at the University of the Philippines, major in cell biology. Then after that, I worked for 1 year. Then I proceeded with the medicine when I was offered to have scholarship as long as I can pass the entrance exam for the scholarship as a medical student. So I entered medicine in the year 1986 and I passed in 4 years. I finished it and had my internship at East Avenue Medical Center in 1990-1991 and passed the board in 1991. I was then, since 1978, a person with disability. So, during that time, I was not aware that there was an existing what we call sector of the PWD. Not until I was already practicing my profession in our town, Kabakan, North Cotabato, where I was born. I was invited as the guest speaker of the PWD organization of the town. And it is only the time that I realized there is really existence of what we call as PWD organizations. From then on, I became active. So I reorganized our town, PWD sector organization. Then I was given an assignment to organize our province, North Cotabato, wherein I became the president of our town, then North Cotabato. Then for the first time, I organized the whole of Region 12, Soxardian. So I became the first president of the Regional Federation of Persons with Disability. From then on, I became active at the sector. I'm already a doctor at that time. And I was involved in the national scene of the disability sector when I was exposed with a campaign, or a Pinoy, I mean, So with the leadership of Colonel Talion, I was trained and I was exposed on what is PWD until they get me as the second nominee of the party list in Akapin, Alyansa na May Kapansanang Pinoy, in 2006, election of 2007. So I became involved in the sector now. I became active until 2016 again. I was again offered to be the second nominee of, again, party list of PWD with number one nominee, one of our blind brothers, Sir Barreto. Then I continued serving the sector in many ways. And that time, unti-unting ginamit ko yung binigay sa akin ng Diyos na pagka-doktor, serving the PWD sector. Everywhere I go, I examine PWDs for free. And that's my promise to them for free, including some of them, including the family. So as a medical doctor. But in our place, I have organized a hospital. We have a hospital at Cabacan, North Cotabato, Cabacan Medical Specialist Hospital. Until 2016, I was invited to work here at City of San Jose del Monte, Bulacan, in one of the biggest hospital in Bulacan. We call it Skyline Hospital.
Okay, guys. We will be back after the message.
In Davao City until from 2009 to 2016, and on August 1, 2016, I transferred here at City of San Jose del Monte, Bulacan. I was employed in one of the biggest hospitals owned by my former classmate at the University of the Philippines, the management team, until now, until this time, I'm still employed with that hospital. But we are not reporting since because of the COVID. So my involvement in the PWD sector, when I arrived here in 2016, I tried to organize the PWD locally, then we expanded it until it became a national organization, and it was founded on sometime summer of 2017, what we call as Pambansang Koalisyon na May Kapansanan para sa Pagbabago, or PKKP. So we celebrate the anniversary every 25th of November of the year. So last 2019, November, it is our second year anniversary. We usually celebrate it at Quezon City. So it's composed of almost all leaders of PWD nationwide. And we have 16 regions, we have leaders. And we yet to complete the provincial city heads of PKKP. So we are still on the process of really gaining membership, because we have the main mission of uniting the persons with disability in the Philippines, since we have different kinds of disabilities with different missions, and there was nobody that unites or that serve as one voice, as a one voice only of PWD. That's why we are never heard in the government. But for the last few years, a year or two, we were started to be invited in the Philippine Congress since they have already formed a special committee on PWD concerns. So last February, we were invited twice for a meeting with the Philippine Congress headed by, with the special committee headed by a wheelchair user, Congresswoman Lourdes Arroyo of Negros. So in that, it was the first time that we can ventilate, and we had express our concern, our advocacy regarding PWD, so that it can be heard by several interagencies of the government, including some congressmen involved in that committee. For now, there are two bills filed for the creation of Commission on Persons with Disability in the Congress, and we have visited the Senate, and also there was a Senate bill filed by Senator Subiri for the creation of Commission on Persons with Disability, and we volunteered ourselves in other PWDs to be present during the committee hearing so that they can hear really and they can formulate the right law. Because we do believe that there's the saying that nothing about us without us. So then here comes the COVID, there was a big problem and everything was halted. Although there was a Zoom meeting with the Congress, but we were just invited to be sort of spectator only, but we have no participation. I do not know why. So we are waiting for the invitation for meeting of the special committee because there's really a need that they will really know what the problem, especially during the COVID time, wherein most of the PWDs were abandoned in terms of SAC program, etc. So that's the direction of the of our organization. And at the same time, I never forget that as a medical doctor, we did with one of our doctor, Richard Yusef from Tugigaraw, Dr. Albert Tillon, we offered an online teleconsultation for PWDs, especially during COVID time up to now. And we are happy that there is only one or two PWD that saw home on the COVID. And so we can see that if the PWDs were, they really followed our advices of the government to not really go out if it is unnecessary and practice other preventive measures. So the vulnerable sector, they call it the PWD, were able to survive COVID without much death on the PWDs in the Philippines. So for now, I'm still working here as in my own medical clinic at City of San Jose de Monte, Bulacan, and entertaining patients not only now PWD but other people who can see my Facebook page or Facebook account that I do entertain teleconsultation or through telephone or through messenger. So that's the overview of everything. So for now, I am a wheelchair user, but I can walk a short distance only with a walker because I'm in pain for the last 42 years of my life. Every step I made, I am in pain, severe, excruciating pain in my hips. I did not undergo any total hip replacement because it's so expensive. Now you have to have 1 million. So I got the degree of the question earlier. I got the degree of Doctor of Medicine for free. My parents are teachers for free. I was able to graduate as class valedictorian of our class in the College of Medicine of the Mindanao State University. And I'm being proud that despite of my disability, kung sa Tagalog, it's not balakid. It depends all in our dreams. Once we really wanted to fulfill our dream, now we can do it. It's just a matter of mind setting. So I'm so proud that I performed well in our class, as class valedictorian during our graduation. And successful medical practitioner, shall I say, because I organized our hospital and I handled it as president of the corporation for how many years. But now I am employed in the Skyline Hospital and Medical Center. I have two kids, one with second year medicine now, and one is grade 12 at Ateneo Davao. They are all studying at Davao Medical School, my eldest. My wife is also a doctor, a pediatrician. So I think that's all for now. Unless there are some other questions, please.
Billy, may tanong ka?
Yes, Doc. Regarding your current condition, paano po kayo nakakapag, how do you do your service to your patients? Like, regardless of the situation, kahit na mayroon kayong kahit despite being a PWD yourself, how do you do service to patients in your community?
There's no effect. My disability has no effect on my practice. Because, you know, having this kind of practice, our medicine, ang kailangan natin is our mind, our intellect, our wisdom from God. So our physical disability, my physical disability was never a hindrance for my practice. Patients go here, PWDs go here in my clinic, and as I told you earlier, I offered a teleconsultation so that they will never go to hospitals and clinic. And once I evaluated that I can treat them through online teleconsultation or online consultation, then submit. I do my prescription by taking pictures of the prescription and sending it to their messenger, and the pharmacy will honor it because I have my signature, my professional tax receipt, and at the same time, let's number. So I can serve anybody, not only PWDs for now, because some are very afraid of going to clinics or even to hospitals because of the COVID situation. So I am functioning as if I'm normal because I just can't walk. So it's never a hindrance in my practice for the last, since 1991, I am a doctor now. So for the last 38, 39 years, I am a medical doctor and I'm a PWD during those times since I became a doctor. And it has no effect. My physical condition has no effect on my medical practice.
That's good to hear, Doc. So, kung if you are able to still continue your medical practice, kahit po may ganyan kayong condition, what are the main factors that keep you motivated to continue serving for people in the community?
Well, my burden to the PWD sector really pushed me to serve them. Burden of what? When I realized that I was so blessed, I am so blessed that despite my condition, God gave me the opportunity to become a doctor, a medical doctor for that matter. And it's so rare that having this kind of disability, I studied medicine, I'm already a PWD, I finished medicine, I graduated with high performance, I'm already a PWD, I had passed my internship, a rigorous internship, a very competitive internship at Isa Avenue Medical Center, running from first floor to second to sixth floor without elevator if it is not functioning. I survived it for 365 days and I was able to hurdle the medical board exam once, one take only. And during those times when I was in the University of the Philippines, I'm not so lucky in terms of vehicle because I was given by my father a motorcycle because the University of the Philippines, Los Baños, has very big campus. So I was given a motorcycle since I can't walk well. But after a few months, it was car now. Again, our car was given to me by my father until during my medical days and during internship, I bought it at this Avenue Medical Center. 2 weeks before board exam, I had a boarding house in front of the UST. Again, 2 weeks before board exam, my car was car now. Again, last year, I'm working at the Fairview as a land transportation office, as an LTO accredited doctor, what I mean, in one of the clinics. Again, my vehicle SUV RAV4 was at Carnap, wherein there was a good news that I can maybe claim it by next week already because it is recovered by CIDG and now it's in temporarily impounded at the Malolo CIDG station. So those things are things not only my disability, but those kinds of things, I just make myself composed and always finding ways not to be affected by practice. Because now the teleconsultation, I never charge any single cent. Remember that I never charge any single cent. So I'm serving them for free, almost all of them. Some give me love gifts, and well, I just accept it. But my service to, especially to PWDs, napakarami pong nagtatanong sa mga sakit-sakit, and I think I have helped much and I will continue to help it. And that's my passion with PWDs, and not only PWDs, it all patients who seek my help as a medical doctor.
Okay.
Sorry. Namit ako na matagal. Doctor, that's a really good statement. Kahit po may PWD kaya, you still continue to serve for the people in the community. That's why your story is so inspiring. So, ang palagay ko susunod na magtatanong ay si Cedric. Better get your questions ready.
Good evening po, Dr. Otto. May tatanong po.
Yes.
Di ba po disability? Paano mo naging successful? Paano mo nagawa mo? Halimbawa, yung naging doctor ka mataas ang position, paano mo may i-share mo sa mga kapwa ng PWD, mga may gusto maging doctor kagaya mo?
Well, it's just, number one, it's just a matter of having a mindset, which I call it a positive mindset. If those who are listening now have a dream to become a medical doctor, go for it. Well, we don't have money for study as a physician, but I was able to find a way that there was a scholarship grant that time when I wanted to become a doctor. Because my parents are both teachers, and we know that the salary of teachers are just so low that we cannot send a certain individual to become a doctor. So it's just a matter of finding ways, number one. And if you are interested, you can do it. So I think that's it. That's the one that pushed me. And what made me more interested to become a doctor is my condition, my disability.
Nice.
Me because I really wanted to know my condition because I'm not convinced with the explanation of my doctors that time. So I wanted to become a doctor and really know what happened with my hip joint.
Sa mga kapwa PWD, daming said kay Dr. Toto, despite my condition or PWD, huwag po tayo mawalan ng pag-asa. Pag-unago, kailangan sikap, lakas ang loob, at walang imposible. Maging successful, yan.
But we should never, we should never forget that with the help of really God, yan po yung pinakamalaking bagay. Pray for it and ask wisdom and ask direction and commit everything to God and that's it. You will succeed.
Tama po. Tapos, Doctor, may tatanong ako. Ilang years ka po nag-train ka po bago ka naging doctor po?
Well, standard po yan after elementary 6 years, high school 4 years, college 4 years, that's a pre-med. Then standard 4 years for the college bachelor for the medicine proper. Then you are required to undergo internship for 365 days or exactly 1 year. And after that few months, you are now allowed to take the board. So that's it. Elementary 6, for high school 4, college 4, then medicine 4 years, then internship 1 year, and that's it. The next few months, you will take the board, and you will become a doctor once you pass. I did not have a special training or a specialization because I am really hard up in walking that time. I could hardly walk after my internship, so I did not apply for specialization na tinatawag or yung mga special training to become a surgeon, internist, or whatever specialization. So I'm a general practitioner since I passed board exam in 1991. Any more questions, sir? Hello? Hello? Anybody?
Sorry. On? Doc, may tatanong. Si Ashu naman magtatanong. Have you prepared any questions?
I greatly put, Doug. Before we proceed to my question, may tayo po dito sa YouTube po si Christian Chan. Well, sabi niya, greatly po, doctor. May I ask, as a doctor, are you currently on the end COVID-19 cases right now? What can you say po about the way and COVID-19 being handled? What specialization are you as a doctor po?
I'm not a specialist. I'm a general practitioner, number one. That's the answer. Number two, yes, I have handled, I'm still handling some COVID patients, but not directly involved in the admission of these patients. I refer it to accredited hospitals of COVID centers within the area where I am practicing, but I just monitor them initially before I refer them until I evaluate that they are really positive for COVID through the rapid test and also the what we call as SWAT test. So I'm not directly handling it in the hospital because number one, my age now is 57. I have the predisposing conditions like heart failure. I have hypertension and diabetes, wherein I am so vulnerable to have a COVID infection. So they don't allow me to go inside the hospital if we are highly exposed to COVID. I just refer them and I initially diagnose them before I refer them. Thank you.
Okay. Ito yung pisa akin.
Ano ito ako? Ito ko yung
pisa. Kaya ako muna. Hello, Miss Len. Ako muna magtatatubo, ha?
Opo.
Hello? Ako muna magtatanong, ha? Hello?
Hello? Go ahead, go ahead, go ahead.
Yes, ako muna magtatanong. May mga iba-iba lugar na po ba sa Pilipinas na putahan mo na? Tapos, ano pa yung mga para sa inyo po? Address yung goals ninyo?
Ma'am, hindi ko nakuha yung tanong ninyo. Paki-clear.
Ayun!
Yung iba po, pwedeng manahimik muna. I-mute ninyo yung kaninyo. May mga bata o what yung necessary noise so that we will have a clearer hearing, please. Ma'am, come again with your question po. Hello? Moderator? Hello?
Yes.
Paki-facilitate sir moderator kung nawawala ako kasi hindi maganda yung flow. Just a comment. So what's the question po nung isa?
Sino po magtatanong? Sino? May question. Sir, anong tanong? Mayroon daw question po si Ginoong Raylan.
Patay.
Okay. Sino po may nagtatanong? Either. Guys, okay, ito na. Mayroon daw tanong si Ginoong Raylan. Base na sa comment, Doc Toto, question, paano mo inumpisan yung inyong PWD at paano mo inumpisan yung PWD organization mo?
Well, I just contacted because I was so exposed with PWD leaders in the Philippines since I became second nominee of party list twice in 2007 election and 2016 election. So I was already exposed with several released in 16 regions sa Cali. When I'm here at Lacan, we have already organized the Mindanao League of PWDs, wherein I was elected during that time as the president of Mindanao PW League. But after a few months, after 2 months, I was called to work here at City of San Jose del Monte, Bulacan. And those leaders that already know, 2, 3, or 4 of us started through group chat until we invited several leaders until we had a meeting at the Agricultural Training Institute, Department of Agriculture at the Elliptical Road, Quezon City. And we organized the what we call as Pambansang Koalisyon na May Kapansanan para sa pagbabago. Then we had an election wherein I was elected as national president. And we have a re-election last November 25, 2019. Again, I was re-elected for another 3 years as the national president. And now we have completed the 16 regional heads of PKKP and some city and provincial heads. So it became bigger and bigger. And our membership is much, much bigger now compared with 2 years ago when we started it, or 3 years ago in 2017. So we are still on the process of possibly increasing more membership so that we can have a unified persons with disability sector in the Philippines, really, to voice out the advocacies of PWD, because that's the lacking factor. The advocacy, we have existing laws for several decades now. For example, the Batas Pambansa 344 Accessibility Law was present since 38 years ago, if I'm not mistaken, but still, wala hong ngipin. There's no the implementation and the those who don't follow the BP-344, wala pong naparusahan. And when we had a meeting at the Congress of the Special Committee on Persons with Disability Concern, it was brought up because agencies are responsible for it, for example, the Department of Transportation and other departments, have no record that meron pong naparusahan because hindi po sila sumusunod. And several PWD laws in place na hindi ho ini-implement. Even yung bullying sa 9442 pati, etc., etc., and even yung pinakabago na, ang tagal-tagal na, ang tagal ginawa ng IRR na 10070, creation of persons with disability affairs office, hindi ho na-implement, ilang percent lang ang may pidaw. Karamihan po ng munisipyo, province, and cities ay may tinatawag nating pidaw-pidawan lang. They did not follow the implementing rules and regulations of PIDAW Republica 10070. Ang dami yung masapin pa na dapat maayos. So, nandito po tayo para pupukin yan. And with the new leadership of the National Council for Disability Affairs under Engineer Ime Rojas, who was appointed, I think, last month, sana magbago na rin po na talagang matutulungan nila ang sector because they are under DSWD and they are the ones in charge for us. And we are just a private organization. By the way, PKKP is also accredited as civil society organization of the DILG Central Office. So we are involved with the DILG. So yun po tayo, registered tayo, etc. So ganyan ko po paano inumpisa yung organization until we grew. Thank you po.
Okay. Salamat po, Roylan. May follow-up question. Kung ikaw po ay magiging boses ng mga PWDs sa Kongreso, ano po ang magiging unang batas mo po?
Kung hindi pa rin maipasa yung creation of commission on persons with disability, I have to refile that and see to it that it will pass because it will be the answer of all the problems of PWDs, especially on the existing laws. Ang dami hong batas, wala hong kwantas, wala hong ngipin dahil wala nga pong nag-aasikaso. Hindi ho pinansin ng ibang agencies, supposedly na, with due respect, agencies such as under ring NCDA, yung DSWD, DIMG, handling the LGUs, etc., ho, wala po. So even the, so yung creation of commission, yan po isang answer. Kasi halos lahat po ng sector may commission na. Commission on Indigenous People, Commission on Youth, Commission on etc. etc. Tayo po ang napabayaan. And by the way, even the issuance of one, hindi nila magawa ng tamang protocol or tamang standard way of issuing a PWID na naging controversial po ngayon sa ating bansa. Na merong isang pamilya na merong ID lahat just to avail of the 20% discount ng food. That's wrong. Pero wag nilang i-generalize. Masyadong blinote ng mga media regarding that, pero iilan lang po yan kasi may mga talagang posibleng malalakas sa mga LGUs o mga DSWD na nag-i-issue ng IDs ng PWD. That's why merong ganon. Isipin nyo, yung mga nag-discover yun, pare-pareho ang number ng ID. So, there must be a way. There must be a proper way of issuing really. And gawin po siyang national. National po yung hindi iba-ibang ibang LGU na karami. So, gugulog po yan, magulog. So, yan po yung mga uunahin natin. Yung maipasa at maligawan ang Senado. Na meron din silang version ng creation, yung creation of meron naman na kay Congress, Senator Supiri, creation of Commission on Persons with Disabilities. And number two, I would encourage the NCDA. Basic po masyado. Wala po tayong comprehensive profiling of PWDs in the Philippines. If you will ask NCDA or DSWD, they can never you get an accurate answer on how many PWDs are there in the Philippines. So how can they have a comprehensive program for the different kinds of disability when in fact they don't have a data on how many PWDs with the category of different categories of disability. So wala po yan. So pwede pong magawa, ipagawa rin po yan. Yan yung mauunahin. Then implementation of existing from the Magna Carta 7277, Batas Pambansa 344 Accessibility, the PDAO 10070, etc. And bullying Act of 9442, other economic activities for PWD. Thank you.
Sige, may isa pang question. Ano po ang layunin ng PKKP org sa ngayon?
Ang pinakalayunin po, wala kaming nakita existing PWD organization in the Philippines na sinasakop niya na maging mag-act to become an umbrella organization of all PWD's existing organization. That's why our membership is open to other organizations para magkaisa po ang PWD. So we will have a unified PWD sector in the Philippines and it's having to have a stronger voice. So kaya nga po during the selection of officers, election of officers, it is open to everybody, a membership, regardless kung member ka ng ibang organization. Basta ang layunin po is a unified PWD sector so we can have a stronger voice to voice out sa ating mga inaing at mga pangangailangan.
Okay, si Asher may tanong. Si Asher may follow-up question. May mga future plans po ba kayo at ano ang magiging plano ninyo for the future?
Na-answeran ko na yung iba niyan. Malaki pa ang usapin niyan sa future plan. Kagaya niyan, wala pa namang nangyayaring creation of persons with disability. Yung comprehensive profiling is not a joke kung paano yung implement all over the Philippines para malaman natin ilan talagang PWDs at ilan ang bawat category. So yan yung mga future na dapat ma-establish natin. And of course, patulungan ng PWD by sitting with the other agencies, the government, to really help the PWD on sustainable economic activities para hindi naman masyadong dependent ang mga PWDs sa mga magulang nila and other mga nagbabantay sa kanila and even in the gobyerno na kung pwede is functional ang mga PWD by having a initial help from the government para magkaroon sila ng kabuhayan at masusustain yung kabuhayan na yon at mabuhay sila sa sarili nila na hindi tayo burden sa government but we are an asset sa government. Those are the future plans.
At sabi ni, may question pa si Danmar. Bakit yung mga PWD bawal pa rin lumabas ng bahay sa kawalan trabaho, lalo na sa ngayong taon dahil sa pandemya?
Hindi. Well, hindi naman bawal. We're encouraging everyone to go out. But of course, during pandemya, abnormal po ang lahat. So, PWD or not, you are bawal talaga maglabas ng wala ka ng mga important puntahan. So, kung ikaw pa, wheelchair-wheelchair ka lang dyan sa daan at bawal talaga. So, hindi lang yan, ibang klaseng disability pa. Even normal persons, abled persons, bawal mo mamasyal-masyal kasi that's the rule, ng quarantine rule, ng IATF, para lang sa atin din, sa kalusugan natin, eh, hindi tayo makahawa, or hindi tayo mahawaan, I mean, or possibly makahawa tayo pag nawalan ng pagdating natin sa ating bahay, makahawa na naman tayo, etc. So, stay at home ang pinaka-advice talaga. So, it's not actually bawal. But during normal times, we encourage everything, every PWT to go out, even during election. Pero ang nangyayari po, ano, hindi sila nag-register, kaya talo lagi tayo sa party list because they don't even bother to register themselves sa COMELEC na pwede naman silang bumoto, pwede samahan sila ng guardians or parents para bumoto. So, nga po tayo, wala pong support sa PWD sector mismo because ang malaking blunder po doon is they are not registered with COMELEC, so wala po. So, we encourage every PWD to go out. Dati kinahiya ng pamilya yan po, pero hindi. So, ngayon po is dapat educate sila na they are part of the society and tayo wag natin i-discriminate mismo yung sarili natin.
Okay, may tanong si HNI Admin. Paano nagsimula ang pambansang koalisyon ng may kapansanan para sa pagbabago? How did the PKKP started?
Sir, kung nakinig kayo kanina yung nagko-question niya, na-explain ko na ang mahaba kanina. When I arrived here from Mindanao, I am from Cotabato, Davao area. I arrived here August 1, 2016. I started chatting some of the leaders here in Bulacan and other parts of Luzon that we should convene once and for all and try to organize a group. And yan po, pinanganak yung PKKP. We had the first meeting sometime in 2017 summer at the Agricultural Training Institute Convention Center at the Department of Agriculture sa Elliptical Road and attended well by different leaders in Metro Manila and Karatig lugar within the Luzon, walang pag-business in Mindanao at the time, kahit biglaan. And we organized PKKP. Doon na po na-come up yung pangalan na several names were suggested and ang approved ng body is pang koalisyon, may pansanan para sa pagbabago. And there, elect ng officers, na-register sa SEC, and in-expound namin pa lahat na ng regions. So yun po yung started dalawa, tatlo, apat lang kami sa chatting. Then lumaki ng lumaki po.
Okay.
Okay, hopefully I have answered their question. Kung meron pa.
Meron pa, meron.
Just feel free to ask.
Meron. Ano po ang layunin ng PKKP in the future? And then, ilan ba ang miyembro sa PKKP so far? Ilan ba kayo?
So far ngayon, walang exact number because of the COVID. Wala pong updated members, but we have almost all 16 regions we have existing members, but the exact, sa akin lang kasi sa listahan ko, or more on the leaders, the exact number of members, every region, province, or kung wala po tayong data pa ngayon kasi wala pa ako kami nag-meet since COVID. So, hindi ko na i-discuss agad yung future. Makinig na lang po kayo sa sinasabi kong answer para hindi na po paulit-ulit yung sinasagot ko. Na-answeran ko na po kung ano future plan ng PKKP. Tatlong beses na po.
O sige. Then may isa pa. What are the plans? Yung base yung sinagot mo kanina, may isa pa from HNI Admin. Kasi pasensya na po, Dr. Toto. 5 minutes na lang po sa Zoom natin. And may one last before we go on a break for a short time. What are the, pagkatapos ng COVID-19 pandemic, ano po ang dapat nating inaasahan ng pambansang koalisyon? Do we need to expect more activities after the pandemic?
That could never be answered because we will never know how many years more na magtagal ang COVID. Yes. So we will just cross the bridge if we are there and we are just having some Zoom meeting with the officers for the plans, ganun-ganun. And we pinangarap na namin yan na magkaroon ng national summit ang mga PWD leaders na i-help kung saan. At from the first year of PKKP, ang problema dyan na ang financing, hindi basta-basta yan. Kasi national leaders, national summit, to once and for all, unify the PWD sector. Kung kailan, hindi natin alam. Kung kailan matapos ang COVID, hindi rin natin pwedeng masabi yan. Kasi that's very uncertain kung kailan po.
Okay, salamat. Any questions so far?
Thank you, Sir Carlos. May last question na lang po sa kay Ms. Chan Chan. Message po to future doctors po before tayo mag-break. Ano? Yung question na lang po ay yung message po sa mga future doctors po. Message po para sa mga future doctors po.
Na PWD?
Opo.
Well, ilan lang kasi ang PWD na fresh na magiging doktor. Ang antipad ko lang, ang una talaga na doon na re-expose dahil nasa showbiz sa Nunoy Siniga. Isa medical doctor. Sa sector ho namin sa PKKP ngayon, dalawa lang po ang medical doctor na alam po wheelchair user ako at si Dr. Albert Dillon ng Tuligaraw na may hospital din sa Tuligaraw City. Marami yung may dentist po tayo. So yung mga gusto mag-doktor, huwag niyong pansinin yung inyong kapansanan as long as kaya ninyo. So kung physical lang ang inyong kapansanan, hindi po balakid yan. As long as accessible yung medical school na pupuntahan nyo, yun. And of course, handa kayo in terms of expenses. For those who don't have scholarship and go, if you will go to private school, yan ang pinakamahirap. You have to have at least 1 million pesos para matapos ka mag-medicine. But for me, I studied, I finished my doctor of medicine for free. Remember that. So go for schools like scholarship and maintain the high grade so that every year you will be qualified to have a scholarship. So pag pinangarap nyo at gusto ninyo, pwede nyo magawa po yan. Hindi po balakid yung may kapansanan.
Okay.
Okay na po, thank you. Okay na po. Take away the tires na. Okay, go.
Okay. Sorry po, H&I admin told me that we only have 2 minutes, almost a minute na lang left before we go on for a short break and we will send you another link. May tanong kasi ako, Dr. Toto. What is the, for your organization, which is the PKKP, does that organization have a mission and vision?
Yeah, we have mission and vision. Na may mention ko na kanina, ang pinaka-mission namin is to unite the PWD Philippines. No, mission, vision namin. Kasi yan talaga yung kulang sa atin. Walang unification. Napakaraming organizations, hundreds of PWD organizations, but walang umbrella organization. That's why pag kumakanta tayo ng missing different tunes, kaya hindi tayo naririnig sa taas. So, our mission is to have really a unified PWD sector in the Philippines. Yan yung main namin.
Okay, guys. Okay, guys, we only have 5 more minutes left to go before we end the show. Guys, any last minute questions? Asher, BD, or Zedric before we wrap up our show?
This is my last question kay Dr. Sana masinig ko talaga. If yung PKKP po ba may plans na mag-expand to more areas in the country, or have you yet to execute any plans na PKKP na mag-expand na po? If yes,
mag-expand, we are existing, sinasabi ko sa inyo. Ang sa amin kasi, we are organized dito sa national, baliktad eh, hindi sa grassroots na kumpita.
Can you go on? Because we're about to run out of time. Because we have to make way for SRO. please, Doc Billy, and have something for you, Doc Toto, after the end of the show. Doc Billy, you have any last minute questions before we make way for SRO?
Wala na po akong maitatanong.
Oh, sige.
Ask the questions I prepared. I prepared enough questions during this show. So, yun na lang po. Wala na akong other questions na maitatanong pa.
Okay, Doc Toto, we have a certificate of appreciation, Hans Inclusion Certificate of Appreciation. This is granted to Dr. Teofilo B. De La Cruz Jr. for his participation in the Inclusive Report exclusive interview today, July 22, 2020, signed by Mr. Roylan Gorospe Marlang, founder and president. On behalf of HNI Philippines, we thank you, and it's been a pleasure to have you in our interview for tonight, and hope for the best for the future, Doc Toto.
Yeah, thank you so much. It's a pleasure, and it's a big opportunity for me to share to you that is some of our disability concerns, and especially in the organization of Pambansang Koalisyon ng Kapansaran para sa Pagbabago. I'll just give you my email, and just email that maybe the certificate of appreciation.
I'm sending it to you now on Messenger.
The Messenger. So thank you so much for inviting me.
Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure.
There are other chance to be invited and speak in the for the sake of the PWD sector. I am more than willing just invite me in advance time.
Thank you
so much for the panelists and for Roylan who invited me. Maraming salamat po. And
may God bless.
Na-record po ba ito sa YouTube?
Yes, we're all live. We're all live.
Yes.
We're all live.
Facebook and YouTube.
So and just give me sa group chat natin anong link nung titignan ko sa YouTube so that I can share it with the members of PTTV.
Okay. Thank you. And on behalf of HNI Philippines, this is Carlos Kanashi. Together with me, Billy Makuse, Zedric, and Asher, and together with Roylan, thank you very much for joining us for the TIR. Have a good night, and may God bless us all. Together, one inclusion forever.
One inclusion forever.
HNI, God first.
HNI, God first.
Thank you. May God bless us all.
Thank you so much, Doc, for
thank you.
For this. Maraming po.
Okay, guys, we will make way for SRO. I will be back on StreamYard tomorrow for the editorial segment. Thank you. Thank you, Cedric. See you this Saturday.
We'll see you too on tomorrow.
Thank you.
Koalisyon ng May Kapansanan para sa Pagbabago. Kanina ko pa naririnig yung word na pagbabago. Dumalong po sa amin isang taga-DILG as last step for the accreditation of CSO sometime last month. It's good that we received that we will be one of the new CSO to be accredited tomorrow. Yes. MOSAID. Thank you very much. Well, we claim that we represent the sector of PWD since we operate nationwide. We have all regional heads, some provincial and city heads, and still going on. Ang sa amin lang po, number one ko, i-summarize ko yung sinabi ng aming secretary, si Ma'am Pre. The council that handles the persons with disability in the Philippines for how many decades, under DSWD with due respect, the NCDA did nothing good for the PWD sector. Why? Pag may question ho, ang sinasabi lang nila, we are just monitoring body. Hello, monitoring body. Kung may kapalpakan, monitor ka kapalpakan. That's why we submitted at DILG a supplemental position paper to implement fully the UNCRPD or United Nations Conference for the Rights of Persons with Disability.
Yes.
Wherein the Philippines is a signatory. We want a rights-based PWD sector, not a welfare-based. Yes. May okasyon. Disability Week, in honor of Apolinario Mabini. Bibigyan ang bawat isa ng 2 kilong bigas, 2 dilatang sardinas, tapos na. International Day for Disabled, December 3. Hanggang doon lang po, papogi, picture, picture, accomplishment. Hindi po yun ang kailangan namin, right space. Napakatagal na ho ng BP 344, Batas Pambansa 344, or what we call as accessibility law, almost 37, 38 years na. Saan po ang ngipin? May naparusahan ba ni isa?
Wala.
Wala. Ngayon po, itong hotel na ito kanina.
Yes.
Sabi ng Gotia, hindi kami pwedeng bumaba doon. At 3 lang ang reserve ng DILG. I don't care in ano yung reserve ng DILG. We are visitors here as PWD. So I asked the manager, which is the manager? Isang tanong, meron ba kayong provision kahit isang parking lang doon sa baba na may PWD? Wala. Wala na. Bakit bukas yung hotel nyo?
Oh, violation nyo.
Batas pa ba sa tipong Google mo ninyo niyan. Tama! The parking area must be the nearest the ramp or the elevator. Period. Ginagawa ho namin yan. Kung kami ang gagawa ho yan, hindi matatapos nationwide. Kami ho, 2 kami taga San Jose del Monte, Bulacan dito. Pero I am from Davao City. Star Mall, McDonald's, everything, nagkaroon ng parking because of our complaint. We are asserting for our rights. We are not demanding for special treatment, but we assert our rights as persons with disability. Kami lang sa education, isalin ninyo yan. Everybody must be educated, including the guardia. PWD parking, with due respect with senior citizen, are for PWD. It is not for buntis, it is not for senior citizen. You are able, you can walk. So yung may mobility problem, kaya nilagay po yan sa batas. Pag tinignan nyo, ang dami ko na ako sa Facebook, kumuha ko, nagpa-credit ako as doctor of LTO last month. Hindi nila mababa yung computer. Napakataas o, napakatarik. Kinarga po ako. Documented ko yan. Air Asia, the oldest domestic airport na EA4. Wala ko silang ramp, walang tube. Kinarga ako, umuulan. E ko nahulog. So nagpail ako ng kwan. Ngayon, nag-text sila. They are looking into it. Hello, ang yaman-yaman ninyo. Ano lang naman yung mobile na rampa na may gulong na pwede yung pang-ramp din pagpunta ng aeroplano? And worse so, sometime last year when we submitted a proposal as executive order for the creation of persons with, for the creation of commission of persons with disability sa Malacanang. Hindi ko kami nagkamali ng pasok dahil yung mga gwardiya doon kami pinapasok. How can this end? Paano mag-enter ito na hindi accessible mismo yung pinapasokan sa amin? Sa Malacanang po yan, with due respect. Hello? So what is the... Anong ginagawa na nagmo-monitor? Monitor lang ang NCDA? So it's time now we propose for the creation really of commissions on persons with disability so that the persons with disability are not burden for the society or the government, but we are partners and we can contribute kahit papano sa gobyerno. Thank you po.
Dahil yun po yung kanyang damdamin, salamat po sa inyong atensya. Kaya lang po, for the last record po, ang person with disability, kapag mag-invite po kayo, times 2, kasi kailangan po ng personal assistant. Yun po yung hindi natin alam. So awareness today and recognition dito po sa ating bagong constitution. At ito po, what's in for them? What is useful to your audience? There are lots of persons with disability in the whole world. And in the Philippines lang po, pinabayaan.